Okay. So, my journey with men, when I was 17, I tried to commit suicide over this guy because he and I had been dating for a couple of years. So yes, I was a teenager dating, but I graduated when I was 17 and I graduated early. We were gonna go ahead and get married. Let me tell you how far we had gotten. Bought the house, literally bought the house in our names. Even had the utilities turned on. Wedding invitations, I did say I never got an engagement ring. He had bought me an engagement ring. Oh my God, I gotta change that. Yes, my first boyfriend bought me an engagement ring. Oh my God. But anyway, bought the ring, the invitations were out, all the bridesmaids, everything was in motion, and then he called it off. Well, I tried to commit suicide because I didn't want to. My primary reason was I didn't want to face the church because they so homed in on, you got to be married. If you want to have favor of God, you got to be married. Well, I'm an embarrassment now, and so I tried to commit suicide. No, I didn't just think about it. I literally tried to commit suicide. All right, so that happened. And then shortly after that, I met this, I didn't meet him. I've been knowing him all my life. And we tried to do a midnight wedding. And so that never actually went anywhere because the marriage license never was mailed in. You know, it was called off that quick. And then, that was a good thing. But then I met Charlie and we dated for 4 months, literally. I mean, so my mind was just all over the place with this, with regard to this marriage thing. So Charlie and I dated 4 months and we met in August, married November 17th of 1981, and that marriage lasted 25 years. In that marriage, Charlie became a minister, became a pastor. We pastored Breakthrough Ministries 16 years. My whole life was about my family, my husband, and all of that, you know. And you know, he'd come home every day. I'd have him something new laid on the couch. You know, he always worked. I always worked. When I did lose my job, he came and told me. He said, "Don't worry." I was crying. "Don't worry about it. I got it." He's always told me that. And just because he was the type of man that said, "I didn't have to work, Lynn, you don't have to work. I got it." I made sure I worked just because he was that type of a man. But nonetheless, that's how that occurred. And then after the 25 years, I started realizing, what am I in this marriage, you know? I look good beside any man, you know, but this man, I don't think I matter, you know, and I did a few things to show that, you know. One of the things I did was that I would call Charlie every day. "How you doing? I was just checking on you." Just call and say whatever. And I was calling him a break, "Hey, baby," type of thing. So I called him every day. But I noticed, you know, getting close to the 25 years, that he never calls me. And so I put it to the test. And day one, the whole day, didn't call. "Hey, what you doing? How you doing?" Day two, day three, day four, day five, day six, day seven, a whole week. And that's when I lost it and I cried. And I'm like, "I'm nothing to you," you know, type of thing. And then I also put it to the test. I said, I'm happy, but I'm not as happy as I could be. Instead of trying to find out what it was, he said, "Well, I don't need you." So that was the response. So anyway, whatever the fuck. Anyway, but as you saw my other videos, after the storm came the calm, and Charlie and I remained friends until his death. And then I went right out of that relationship and met Terrence. And Terrence is an amazing man for me. He really was, because he lifted the man. He was just incredible. My self-esteem shot to the roof because of him. His mind and the way he thinks and his analogy of things were so sexy to me. And that was my sexual awakening, was with Terrence. Terrence and I, we fucked. We made love. Y'all not gonna believe it, but we was just, because I, hey, no apologies, shit. No apologies. And so I remember one time we had a 7-hour marathon, you know. We had a 7-hour marathon, just sex. I had to literally go from there to work and was a zombie that day. But when I divorced Charlie, you know, that was volatile, but then it smoothed it out. And as I said, we remained friends. But when Terrence left, that was very emotional for me. I just cried so hard and all of that, and just stood there and watched him, whatever, you know, because he just couldn't stand to see. It's what he said, you know. Basically, me doing the same thing he was doing. Let's just put it that way. His dad told him, she got a right to do what you're doing. She had a right to do what you're doing. But the thing with him, I wasn't doing anything. He just thought I was. But you get best for damn sure. After he left, it was on. So, the first one I tried to commit suicide. The second one was so hurtful because that was 25 years. But I had to get out of that. And, you know, we had our children and all of that. And then the third one was the one that I fell in love with. And that was more emotional than anything because I really do and did love Terrence. And then the other situation I was in, it wasn't about the broken heart. It wasn't about no, I didn't cry. There wasn't no tears. I just wanted to get back home. And so that's my journey, you know, dealing with men. This last one, I just wanted to get back home. No, nigga, you ain't broke my heart. No, because we wasn't 8 months. It wasn't fused in there, you know. So it wasn't no broken heart. Wasn't no tears at all. I didn't drive home from Pennsylvania crying and carrying on. I just need to get home. And so that's my evolution when it comes, our journey rather, when it comes down to men. That's why I say what I'm saying with regard to relationships. The mindset that I have now, if I were to seek to be in one, I know exactly what I want, but I don't seek to be in one. I'll be 57 in a couple of weeks, December 12th, 3 weeks or so. I'll be 57. And so, do another 25, I'll be almost damn near 80. I'm good. I'm good by myself. We're going to roll this out by myself. But for you younger women, don't let a bad situation, a bad relationship shut you down all the way where you're not open to see what's good standing right in front of you. Happy Thanksgiving, y'all.